Hey guys, Penguin Recordings here, and today I'm going to be showcasing a benchmark video for Counter-Strike Global Offensive running on Ubuntu 14.04 versus running it on Windows 8. So I'm going to go first into the settings, and you'll see I have everything maxed out, 1920x1080p, full screen, and let's see, global shadow quality is set to high, model texture is high, effect detail is high, shader detail is very high, multi-core rendering is enabled, multi-sampling is 8x MSAA, FXAA is also enabled, I don't know why, but I'm just doing it for the fun of it, vertical sync is disabled, and motion blur is enabled. So I'm going to be using GLXOSD on Ubuntu to showcase the frames per second on the screen, and MSI Afterburner on Windows 8, instead of the traditional Valve frame counter inside, because the frame counter is very small and it's hard to see on screen. So on the left hand side is Ubuntu 14.04 and on the right hand side is Windows 8. Now to take note, right off the bat, it is known that CSGO on Linux has less performance than Windows. So what is this video about? I just want to see how much less is it. Is it drastically less or only a bit less? So when we were in the main menu just now, we were seeing both sides of operating systems soaring at above 100 frames per second. Not 120 though, which is a shame. 120 monitors will feel some sort of delay on screen. So Windows 8 is taking quite a while to load the game here, while on Ubuntu 14.04 it loaded up actually a bit too fast. I was a bit shocked when I saw that in the video. So now they are synchronized. You can see that both games have frames above 200 just now. Dropped down to 180, 190 on Ubuntu. We are seeing Ubuntu on 180, 190, while Windows is at 240, 250, 270. So that's a good 50, 60 frames per second difference just now. We're still looking at quite a big difference here. That just now was almost 100 frames per second difference, where Windows went to 240 while Ubuntu was at 160, 150. One thing to note is that both operating systems are able to keep the game running above 120 frames per second. What does this mean? It means it's overkill. If you're running a 120Hz monitor, you're going to be perfectly fine. There shouldn't be any screen tearing if VSync is enabled. You should also be able to VSync it at 60 frames per second consistently, both on Ubuntu 14.04 and Windows 8. However, if you're running a 144Hz monitor, then you may see fluctuations on Ubuntu side compared to Windows 8. We are seeing about 50, 60 frames per second difference here and there, almost up to 100, probably up to 100 difference sometimes, but rarely. Ubuntu side is idling anywhere between 160, 170, 150 just now. Yep, 140, 139. 139 seems to be 137, 131. Okay, 131 frames per second down below. Seems to be a bit hectic here. Even Windows went down just now, but still, Windows is staying at 200 frames per second. Dropped down to 190 while Ubuntu was at 139. So it does get graphically intensive for both systems. However, Ubuntu does experience a greater drop. When we were looking through the When we were looking through the gun's scope, you can see the frames per second drop quite a bit on Ubuntu's side. On Windows as well, but it doesn't go as low as Ubuntu. This is probably why Counter-Strike GO took so long to come out on Linux. Maybe there were some serious performance issues initially in the engine. Looks like they are fixing it out, though it really does feel smooth when you play this though. If you're the kind of person who is okay at gaming 30 frames per second, this game is more than enough already on Ubuntu, no problems there. But if you're looking for real performance, 60, 120, Ubuntu is still good there. It's just that if you're going to 144Hz monitors or above in the future, looks like Windows is still leading there. I wouldn't count this as a loss, but I also wouldn't count this as a perfect win because it's not frame for frame performance. Then again, that can change in the future when they update it some more. They're definitely working very hard there. This could also be an issue with NVIDIA's driver on Linux instead of the Valve engine. I'm still waiting on a newer driver from NVIDIA. We are still seeing consistently about 130, 140, on Ubuntu as low as it goes. I haven't seen it drop below 100, although I am human, so I've made a if I've made a mistake, please let me know. Windows is dropping 180, 190, up, back again. The drops and increases are very high on Windows. Doesn't seem to increment nicely. It goes from 180 straight up to suddenly 250. That's where you can see screen tearing when that happens. So we're ending this on 210, 15 versus 280, 290. Yeah, that's pretty large gap, but in retrospect, since both are above 120 frames per second, it is practically negligible. Down when we go into the main menus, they both have the same frames per second. So that is it for this benchmark video, guys. Basically, what I can conclude here is that the Linux port is still not frame for frame performance when compared with Windows, but it is able to garner above 120 frames per second, at least with NVIDIA hardware and NVIDIA drivers. This could drastically be different for AMD and Intel users. I have no idea how it is for you guys. Share your experiences in the comment below so other people can see it and I can see it. That is it for this video, guys. I know my gameplay is not that good. I was just playing against easy bots. I am not a professional in this game. It's just for fun. I hope this video is a bit informative, and maybe in the future we can take a look again when they've released the Source Engine 2 and see how that goes when that comes out. Hopefully this video is useful to you. I hope you enjoyed watching. Please leave your comments below, regardless of what it is you'd like to say. And thanks for watching, guys.